Hello friends, this is the 10th essay. Yesterday we had the introduction, today we will see sentences 1, 2 and 3. Sentence 1 reads, someone in their discourse, deserve rather commendation. Some people, they speak just for the sake of getting praise, commendation or good comments, or say that, oh, he is a pandit, people will say like that. When? Of commendation of wit, which means commendation of his ability to talk, wit here means his wisdom, not wisdom actually, his ability to talk, in being able to hold all arguments than of judgment, in deciding what is true. All arguments means all topics. So a person starts talking about Shakespearean tragedy. A.C. Bradley's Shakespearean tragedy, but he does not know much about that. He talks 2 or 3 minutes, but he knows about romantic poets, so he shifts to romantic poets. Wordsworth was a nature poet and so on. And then he will go on saying difference between Wordsworth, Shelley and the John Keats. And further he will go, then he will say Tennyson was a great poet. See, he started from Bradley's, A.C. Bradley's Shakespearean tragedy and goes on saying up to the 20th century Ted Hughes he will go. So he thinks that if he goes on talking without any rest or without any what you can say a stop in between, what he thinks that people will think that he knows many things. He is a walking encyclopedia. So commendation of which, but he does not bother whether what he says is up to the point or whether that is what is expected of him. Sometimes some people, what happens, you know, they simply use bombastic words like this. When the splendid meets the magnificent and the magnificent reaches the celestial happiness and the globe, earth, this is no connection between. But they think that if I talk like this, people will praise my wit. So it's for that they are talking. So that of judgment in discerning what is true, that's not what they are concerned about. As if it were a praise to know what might be said and not what should be said. That is the thing. So that is a misunderstanding. Some people who move from one topic to another topic and also without any full stop or any comma or any such thing, see, what happens, they think that if I go on talking like this on any subject under the sun, then people will praise me. But actually, they are not concerned about what should be said. If you start with the Shakespearean tragedy by A.C. Bradley, you should continue to talk. Instead of that, you move from romantic to Victorian to modern poetry and all those things, then Georgian poetry and things like that, or post-war poetry. You are just creating a kind of a bombard. Again, so that is a kind of bombastic. Isn't it? It's a bombastic style. Plus, and also using big words like magnificent, splendid, spectacle, tsunami, and all those things. You talk like that. But they are not concerned about what should be said. That's the point. You can see some people who make welcome speeches. But their business is to welcome the gathering, not any other thing. But what will they do? They will go on for half an hour continuously about some other things. What is the purpose of this meeting? What is the purpose of this institution? What is the agenda of this institution? What are we going to do in future? What are we going to do after the earthquake and all those things? Then halfway through he will say, now let me discharge my responsibility. Half an hour people get bored and tired, we'll go to bed, we'll sleep and so. Then you will hear, such people are mic addicts, microphone addicts. So then they will say, now I am going to discharge my responsibility to welcome the guests who have come here. After half an hour. So they, according to them, they think if they talk like this, there's a commendation of it. And people will praise him, not what should be said. What should be said is, he will say, My duty here is to welcome all of you. This many VIPs have come, names of these VIPs, etc. And also the audience, and also all those people who have come there to ask guests and so on. That's all. It's a matter of 2 or 3 minutes or 5 minutes maximum. But instead, telling the whole story from when God created the Garden of Eden, then what happened and so on. What are the place of this institution there? So they are not saying what should be said. They are saying what comes to their mind. And they think, they are wrongly thinking that such talk, that is, even without any relevance to the occasion, if they go on talking, say for hours, people will, commendation of it means praise them. That's a wrong thing. The second point is like this, some have certain commonplaces and themes wherein they are good and want variety, want. W-I-T, want here means lack, doesn't mean lacking. They have no, here want doesn't mean I want something, no, want means lack. See that, I like, they like something. There are some people I know a person, he's a great man, but he knows only to speak about, he knows some 100 words and some one of the topics. Wherever he is invited to talk, he will be talking the same thing. That's the thing. Putting these 100 words and the same topic here and there, some slight changes. So there are such people, they lack variety. They are not people who are learned or scholars. So somehow, some have certain common places, common subjects and themes, of course, common places and themes, wherein they are good and want variety, they don't have variety. Which kind of poverty, that's a poverty, this, that means they don't have knowledge of many topics, is for most part tedious. Tedious means boring, and when it is once perceived, once found out by people, ridiculous, it is stupid. So, the first defect, what we have seen is, first, I can say, point of criticism is, some people talk without any moderation on all subjects under the sun, thinking that by talking like this, they can win the praise of other people. Without, they are not concerned about the relevance. Without concern, without being concerned about the relevance, if you go on talking on all the subjects under the sun, that is actually a ignorance, so to say, or a misunderstanding that will attract commendation of which or praise for them. No, never. Secondly, there are some people who know only one or two topics. So wherever they go, they will go on talking about that. If you happen to attend the second meeting by the same person, then you will understand. You will perceive, you will understand. What will you understand? He does not know anything. He knows only this. Then you will understand. Then you will feel that, this is tedious. Second time, same thing you are hearing. So tedious, and also it is ridiculous, stupid. Then he says, what is that? These are the two defects. Then third sentence he says, the honorable part of talk is to give the occasion and again to moderate. First of all, talk to the occasion. If it is a welcome speech, just give the welcome speech. If it is a propose a water thanks, give the water thanks. Don't talk about World War I and World War II. Because you know about this, why should you talk and follow this? If we are talking about romantic poets, then talk about them. That is the thing. That is what you have to do. So, the honorable part of talk is to give the occasion. Means talk to the points. That is, you see that what the occasion demands. That's the thing. To give the occasion. What the occasion demands. relevant to the occasion. And again, moderate. Don't go on talking. See, some people, they start talking, they will start in this way, that it is going to be a very long speech. Introduction will take 1.5 hours. Then, there is some, you can see some news reporters, you know, you can see. So you are just going through these columns. Where is the, what is the point? And then the reporter will say, the cloud, then rain, and the finally, last one sentence you will find. That is beating around bush, is what it is. You remember in all studies, Francis Bacon has said that, if you have that defect of your mind, then what should you do? You should study mathematics. And also, the simile sectus, says, to the point. Understand that? That's what he says. Don't beat around the bush. So here it is. Then, to the point. So the honorable part of talk is to give the occasion, that means give what the occasion demands. And again, be moderate. Moderate. That is the golden mean. And pass to someone else. So you are given 20 minutes. 18th minute you should stop. Say your speech. And then give the chance to the next man. Pass to someone else. Someone else. That means pass on to the next person. You take your seat. The other person will take. For then a man leads the dance. So only then, when you give the chance to him, then whatever, the dance will go on. The meeting will go on. Otherwise, half of the people will go out. 20% of the people will die. And 30% of people will sleep. This is what happened. It's very important, isn't it? All the three sentences, this we can see that is wisdom, so to say. Isn't it? Wisdom. As you say, first one is, once again I'll say, the first defect in most of the speakers is they go on speaking without any relevance, thinking that if they take more time for speaking, people will praise their wit. That is ignorance, or you can say a wrong way of looking at things. Second effect is, some people are only one or two topics. Wherever they go, they will go on talking about that. And once somebody finds it out, it is tedious, boring, and also it is ridiculous, stupid, so to say. Yeah. And the third point is that you talk to the point, relevant to the occasion. Second, be moderate, don't be too long. Thirdly, you give chance to others. Then the dance will go on. Otherwise, it will be like butchering all those people who have come there to listen. Is that clear to you? So 3 points today. One defect is talking for a very long time on many topics. Second is that you have only one or two topics, and that you do every day. And third, what you should do is be moderate, be relevant, and also pass on or give chance to the other persons. And that will be, so it's one, that is the honorable part of the discourse. To be honorable, 3 things you have to do. One, relevant to the occasion. Two, for example, a funeral oration, you cannot go and speak about comedy. Understand? You know only comedy, and so you are speaking about comedy. Say something about tragedy at that day. That is. So, relevance, important. Moderate, meaning be short and brief. See that? Or the time allotted to you. 1 minute before the time allotted, you should stop. And then you should give the chance to the next person. Like this, handing over the baton. In relay race, you can see. Relay race, they hand over the baton. Like that. That's 6 chance. Then it is the honorable part of talk. So what is the honorable part of talk? The answer is this one. Hope that it is clear to you. You'll proceed like this. So, my dear friends, take care of your health very much. As a, should stay at home and then don't go out. Also, you tell at least one of your friends to stay at home and take rest or use this time for academic purposes. Don't go out. So, if you stay at home, one plus point is that automatically you are keeping the social distance. It's the most important thing necessary for breaking this chain. Understand that? So, let us do whatever we can during these days of what we call COVID-19. Isn't it? Yeah. So, whatever we can do, instead of cursing darkness, we can light a candle. So at least that means we can hope that we will do something in this way to educate people or to strongly tell people to keep social distance, and thus let us get rid of this pandemic. It is a pandemic, not an epidemic. Okay, see you with another lecture next time on this off discourse. It's a very good, it's good for classroom communication also. There are teachers who don't teach. I mean, I'm not saying there are. In my experience, I have one. They don't come and speak to the point. They speak something else. They talk about something else for a very long time. Means 1.5 hours they will talk. So, there are some others, they say, I cannot take tragedy, I can only take comedy. So in this way, what you should do is, you should do. All kinds of people are there. See, so I am not criticizing or finding fault with anybody. But these are the, if you are aware of these things, then what will happen? You will try to get rid of this. So in that way, you should take what I have said, not as a criticism, by have a nice time, enjoy your life.